Random House Audio presents Medical Myths That Can Kill You and the Truths That Will Save, Extend, and Improve Your Life. This is the author, Dr. Nancy Snyderman. I don't know about you, but I like it here. Sure, life can get complicated, hard to get through, and it's not always fun, but I don't want to be shown the door anytime soon. If there are ways I can enhance my health and longevity with healthy habits, if there are appropriate screening measures for my age group, if there are new life-saving treatments I can access, then I want to know about them so I can stay around and be kicking up my heels when I'm 90. But there is a challenge you and I face. To stay healthy and live longer, we need to understand and evaluate medical myths and learn to act on the truths behind them. Dictionaries define myths as widely held but mistaken beliefs, misconceptions, or misrepresentations of the truth, even exaggerated conceptions of people and institutions. Myths are like smokescreens. They prevent us from focusing clearly on the real issues and options. And for most of the time, we are unaware of the degree to which they shape our thoughts and guide our actions. In Medical Myths That Can Kill You and the Truths That Will Save, Extend, and Improve Your Life, I'll help you figure out what is true, what isn't, and how to punch holes in myths you've come to believe. Medical myths, and there are thousands of them, are alive and well in our culture. In writing this audiobook, I distilled medical mythology down to 7 of the most common and dangerous myths regarding our health, medical care, and longevity. On the flip side of this, at the conclusion of each chapter on myths, I'll give you a number of medical truths, tips, advice, and the latest scoop on how to enhance your health and save your life. Many of these came as questions my patients have brought to me for explanation during my more than 30 years as a doctor. I'll also give you news you can use, vital medical information straight from the headlines that will help you chart and steer your own course to a healthier life. I will explain all these myths, truths, and news to you as I have to my patients and to the viewers I reach through my job as a television medical correspondent. I promise that you'll hear vital medical information in a plain, practical, and straightforward manner. You'll also get an insider's view of how doctors think and talk, so you can understand our language and what it means to you. Knowing this information is one vital way to keep yourself on a healthy course for a lifetime. 2 of our greatest enemies in the battle against life-threatening diseases are ignorance and the personal beliefs we bring into the doctor's office. Are there myths you believe and hold dear? Are there old wives' tales you trust? Being willing to shift your thinking and embrace new ideas may not completely eradicate your disease risk, but they may be the first steps toward making changes in your life that will. This audiobook will give you the medical information you need to help you make informed decisions about how to get connected to the process of your own health care. Yes, there is a process. What tests, screenings, and vaccinations you need to stay healthy and make health decisions that will benefit you most. Demand respect and appropriate treatment from a healthcare system that isn't always fair. Prevent and treat the 3 leading causes of death in men and women: heart disease, cancer, and stroke, through awareness, self-care, prevention, and treatment. Learn to reverse controllable risk factors and potentially add 7 years of healthy living to your life. Discover how a healthy mind influences a healthy body so that you can stay well, remain active, and get the most out of your life. Understanding medical myths clears the way to the truth and helps you see what you need to do for yourself to live a healthier, happier, and more fulfilled life. Along the way, you'll discover there are plenty of health issues over which you have a lot more control than you think. The more you know, the more prepared you are, and the better your underlying health, the better your chances of surviving any medical challenge thrown your way. It is my hope that what I have to say brings renewed health and energy to your life, extends it, and possibly even saves it. Myth number one, annual checkups are obsolete. When I talk to people around the country, I'm always surprised to find that so many men and women believe that annual physical examinations are unnecessary. Very few see their physicians on a regular basis. I realize there are some things we would just as soon not find out, like your boyfriend's or girlfriend's entire sexual history before you met them. But having yourselves checked on a regular basis is a vital step we must all take. If all of us did this, diseases could be prevented or detected at an early stage when treatment is most effective and lives would be saved. I know this from medical experience, but I also know it from personal experience. In 1986, while a surgeon at the University of Arkansas, I was awakened very late at night by a telephone call from my father. The minute I heard his voice, I knew something was wrong. No one in my family ever makes calls after 9 p.m., so this was already unsettling. Age 63 at the time, my father, a doctor who inspired me to become one, had just had his annual physical, which he still faithfully undergoes every year. He believed he was at risk for colon cancer, since his father had died from it in his 60s. So every year, at his annual exam, Dad insisted that he get a sigmoidoscopy, the standard test back then that allowed a doctor to look at the lower part of the colon. But this time, he told his doctor he wanted a colonoscopy instead, a more thorough test that was just coming into its own. My father was convinced that this was the new standard of care and the best tool for investigation. Although being a doctor brings me in close proximity to life-threatening diseases, my mind went numb when Dad told me that the colonoscopy had revealed a mass just beyond the area where the sigmoidoscopy would have stopped. There was a tumor in the wall of the colon that had eaten through and spread to two neighboring lymph nodes. A biopsy had confirmed that the mass was malignant. My dad had cancer. Because it had pierced the colon wall, I knew the situation was grim. I was stunned at just how unprepared I was to deal with my father's getting a diagnosis like this. The fact that my brother and I are both surgeons didn't make this reality any easier. But fortunately, there was a happy ending. The tumor had not spread any further than those two lymph nodes. Because radiation and chemotherapy weren't very effective for colon cancer back then, my father decided that surgery was the best treatment, so he underwent a resection of the colon. He was right and lucky. He has had a couple of scares since then, but now, 22 years later, he has beaten his cancer. Ever since it happened, he's had regular colonoscopies, every year for a while, then every 2 years, and now every 3 years. Colonoscopies aren't necessary that often for everyone, but his testing schedule reveals how individualistic exams must be. If you have had cancer or have a strong family history of it, you and your doctor may decide that an annual look is worth it. The annual checkup is by no means obsolete. It is an important step we must all take, if for no other reason than to make decisions with our doctors about what screenings and tests are right for us. The appropriate scenario for screening depends on our age, risk factors, even symptoms. Whether we take the next step and follow through on those recommendations is our choice, but it is a choice that may set our compass toward living or dying. Anatomy of a myth. Why has the annual physical become such a debatable issue? For most of the 20th century, the annual head-to-toe checkup for adults was the standard of care. Its purpose? to find disease early and reduce a person's risk of death. Then, as now, it involved blood tests, urinalysis, and screenings like chest x-rays and sometimes electrocardiograms. With the evolution of medical technology came bigger price tags, cost-benefit ratios, and public discussions of who will pay for what. Somewhere in the middle of all of this, the patient, you and me, we got lost. So by the late 70s...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.